All the goodness that you're used to in the Defender for Cloud Apps portal is right here in the Microsoft 365 Defender portal, so you can get more done in one place. You don't have to switch portals to sanction or unsanction apps, or review your cloud app catalog and activity log. The Files page is here too, so you can look for sensitive data and create DLP policies. Likewise, user and account information, OAuth apps, and cloud app policies are also in the unified Microsoft 365 Defender portal. And because you can now live in this one place, there's even more you can do. For example, investigate Defender for Cloud Apps alerts correlated with alerts from other service sources into incidents. The Cloud Discovery Dashboard will be familiar. It's an overview of the cloud apps your organization uses, including app categories, discovered apps, and risk levels. Next to that, the Discovered Apps tab lists the cloud apps we've found. By default, we sort this list by risk level, but you can sort by most columns. Of course, filtering this list is immensely useful. We provide basic filters right above the list, but you can use advanced filters to home in on what you need to see, or select an app category, like online meetings, to focus on a particular category. And like the Defender for Cloud Apps portal, select an app to learn more about it, including how we calculated its risk score. App governance is an add-on feature for Defender for Cloud Apps that offers enhanced visibility and control of OAuth apps that access critical information in Microsoft 365. Beyond the overview on the Apps tab, you see a list of OAuth apps used in your organization. For each, you can quickly see its status, permission and consent types, permission usage, and privilege level. Or you can select an app to open its details in the side pane, which include whether it has Graph API access, the consent type, and so on. To give Defender for Cloud Apps even greater visibility and control of many third-party apps, we also offer app connectors. We have a bunch of new ones, but feel free to select Suggest More Apps to give us your feedback. Moving on, the Files page gives you visibility into files from your connected cloud apps. By default, we put the most recently modified files at the top of the list. To the right of each file, select the kebab menu to choose various actions you can perform. The actions available depend on the cloud app, of course, but common ones include opening the file in the cloud app, refreshing the file, viewing related activity, alerts, and governance, deleting or quarantining the file, or removing collaborators. You'll undoubtedly encounter thousands of files in this list, so filtering is invaluable here. The most common filters are available right above the list. In this case, I'll select Access Level, followed by Public Internet, to see only files that anyone on the internet can access. After that, select Public to also show files that anyone with a link can access, followed by External to add files that are shared by external collaborators. Now I have a list of all files shared externally. Sometimes the basic filters aren't enough though, so select Advanced Filters, followed by Add a Filter to add a new criterion to it. In this case, I'll select Last Modified, Earlier Than Days, and type 180 to further filter my list to show only stale files. What I really want to do is remove external collaborators from these files, and I can do that easily by creating a new DLP policy. Select New Policy from Search, give it a descriptive name, and down in the Governance Actions section, choose an app, like Microsoft OneDrive for Business, and select Remove External Users. Of course, we can also create governance actions for third-party apps, like Google Workspace. After creating this policy, Defender for Cloud Apps will remove external collaborators from files that are older than 180 days. But instead of creating policies from scratch, you could just use one of our policy templates, including our built-in templates for third-party apps. Under Policies, select Policy Templates. Find the template you want to use, and select Create Policy. Customize the policy to suit your needs, and then at the bottom of the page, select Create. The last thing I want to show you is the activity log, where you can see all Defender for Cloud Apps activity. It shows what users are doing in their SaaS apps to give you a better idea of typical user behavior in your environment. Select an activity to see more details about it in the file drawer. If you have experience with the Defender for Cloud Apps portal, you'll notice that almost all these pages look the same in both places. The big news here is where they live. Now you can manage Cloud App security in the same place you manage services like Microsoft Defender for Endpoint or Microsoft Defender for Office 365. But there's more to it than just location, location, location. Because Defender for Cloud Apps is now in the Microsoft 365 Defender portal, you get more value from that data. Incident management is a good example. We correlate your Cloud App alerts with alerts from other service sources into incidents that help you focus and save time in your investigations. However, if you want to home in on incidents that contain Defender for Cloud Apps alerts, select Filter, followed by Microsoft Defender for Cloud Apps. Select Apply to update the list. See our incident management article in Microsoft Docs for more information. This article also offers a video, like this one, that describes how Microsoft 365 Defender correlates alerts into incidents. Another example is advanced hunting. Each row in the Cloud App Events table defines a single event in the Defender for Cloud Apps data. We provide a lot of columns here that you can join to other tables to look at your data in new ways. This overly simple example joins the Cloud App Events table to the Identity Info table to add user identity information to each event. To make this even more useful, you can create detection rules based on your queries. These rules will raise alerts anytime the query returns results. The article, Proactively Hunt for Threats with Advanced Hunting, and the video it contains, describes these capabilities in detail. One last example is SaaS Security Posture Management, or SSPM, which you find in Microsoft Secure Score. As you shift left towards prevention, SSPM is critical to ensuring all SaaS apps are compliant and following security best practices. So, we surface app misconfigurations and provide recommendations on how to improve your SaaS app security posture. The list of recommended actions includes all service sources, but you can filter it to show just SSPM recommendations. Select Filters and choose Microsoft Defender for Cloud Apps and any supported third-party apps you want to show recommendations for. Select Apply to update the list. Then select a recommendation to see details about it in the Details side pane, including implementation steps. The article titled Microsoft Secure Score provides more details, and it also contains a detailed video about this capability. Defender for Cloud Apps provides rich visibility and control over data in connected cloud apps. And now, it's in the Microsoft 365 Defender portal, along with service sources like Microsoft Defender for Endpoint. To learn more about Defender for Cloud Apps, see our documentation on Microsoft Docs. Microsoft Security.